Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to do a very quick, or rather small empties video because apparently I haven't finished up a lot of products in July. I am filming it a week early, but when I look at my products I'm just like, you're not going to finish any more products than these. So let's just do the video. I have three non-makeup items and then I have five makeup items I'm going to talk about. So, the least exciting is a dry shampoo. This is Batiste. I love this stuff so much. It says here it's vegan and cruelty-free, but I believe it was cruelty-free kitten or Logical Harmony that don't have it on their list. I'm not really sure. I think I saw that somewhere. Or was it Angelica that said it wasn't cruelty-free? But it says here it is, so I'm really confused. But this is my favorite dry shampoo, so until it doesn't say vegan and cruelty-free on the bottle, I'm buying it. Because this is amazing and it is the only only dry shampoo that really works in my for my hair. So yeah, this is the brunette version because I am of course brunette and the white ones don't work for me. Another hair item I have, it is the Pantene Pro V argan oil. So this is for your hair. Basically, really don't want to talk to you guys. So this was a really nice oil. The product itself was really good. I really loved it. It didn't feel greasy and it didn't weigh in my hair and stuff like that, so it was really nice. My problem with this was that it leaked so bad. So maybe half of the oil I didn't get to use. Well, I didn't use it, you know, but I used the product, I really liked it, but I will never ever buy this again because it leaked. And maybe it's just the packaging fault, but no thank you. And Pantene is not cruelty free, so I can't buy it if I want to. So then I have a night cream. It is from Pure & Care, I believe. No, I don't know where this is from. Denmark? I think it's Danish. I already have a new one of this night cream and it's just a repair and rejuvenated moisture and lift no perfume face cream, night cream. It's just really nice, 50 milliliters. And it comes in a jar. But it's really nice. It's a nice jar. So maybe I can reuse this for something else. It's a glass jar, so it feels like it is expensive, and it reduces plastic that way. Just saying. I don't know if it does, but in my head it does. I have one declutter and that is my L'Oreal Infallible Magnetical Eyeshadow Pigment thingy. These, they were so popular once on YouTube. I found mine. It was lost in my update, but I had it in my declutter drawer apparently. So I just threw it in here. I'm not a fan. I was in the beginning and now it's just here and it fades throughout the day, so it's not really working anymore. It was this beautiful orangey color. It was really beautiful. I did repress some of it into a pan that I'm going to use up, but after that I'm not going to use this. So this is just going in the trash. I don't want to look at it anymore and I'm never going to go through it as an eyeshadow because it's not good anymore, at least. I'm not the best at using pigments, but no, I don't think it works. I have tried several bases with it and it just don't work for me, so I'm not going to take my time to make it work. I have 10 million eyeshadows in my collection that I rather want to use, and that is also orangey, shimmery orange, so no more. Well, this is maybe not that makeup like, but it is a nail polish. It is a spoiler for my it is a spoiler for my product polish. It is my Depend nail polish in the red color. It is 360. They don't have names, but it is this shadow. It is this shade right here. It is absolutely beautiful. Until half the bottle, I used it just alone. It needed a few coats, so it wasn't really good. It is hit and miss with the pen, so this was a miss, but I have used other that are really great. So this little bit right here, I used as an accent. No, what is it called? I don't remember the name right now. You know when it fades on the nail? But Joy for Joyful Beauty, she is amazing at doing those kind of nails. So I wanted to try myself. It was a mess, but I used it up that way. So I'm not mad. I used up a lip liner. Finally, this is the eBay lip liner that I have tried to use up since September. It's finally done. Oh my god. It is this shade 4. So it is this nude color. So if you can see, there's some white in the pencil in the middle. That is the wax. So the pencil only goes down to here, so it was maybe up to here when I started. So it is a massive pencil to begin with. So I knew from prior experience that it didn't go all the way through, but I was so excited when I couldn't sharpen it anymore, and I was just like, done. This is a sad moment. I don't want to say that this is done. I don't want it done. I don't want it to leave my collection. It is the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in Cannes. This shade is amazing. Let me swatch it. So there's still some product in it, but it's too goopy and it doesn't dry down anymore. It transfers everywhere. They normally don't do that. This is a beautiful shade. It's a little bit darker because it's so clumpy and goopy, you know, but it is a beautiful nude color. I absolutely love this shade. So when I can justify buying a new one of these, I will, for sure. It's good. It's one of the better liquid lipsticks you can get. It's drying down so it doesn't transfer, but not drying out your lips, kind of liquid lipstick. Does that make sense? It's really, really beautiful. The last item I have to show you guys is my Max Factor Primer. I'm so sad. This is the saddest moment of all time. I have used my last bottle of this up. I can't buy it again because of its status, but it's being discontinued from Denmark, at least. I don't know internally, but I'm so sad. So I did scrape everything out. It is completely done. I can't get this. I can't. It is the Max Factor Facefinity All Day Primer. This is amazing. If you come across it ever, do it. It's amazing. This is a primer that is someone in between a silicone primer and a creamy primer. It keeps your makeup on for so long, and it is hydrating. At the same time, it is sticky, so it's just so nice. And I'm so sad that I can't get it anymore. I'm so sad. This is so good. And my best friend, she put me up to this, and sometimes I hope she didn't. I wish she didn't, but she did, and now I need to find something that is similar. It's going to be hard, but I will say, to end this on a happy note, Rebecca Morgan, you are a darling. She sent me the CoverGirl primer that is supposed to be a dupe for this. CoverGirl and Max Factor is fairly similar, actually, and I don't know why they pulled out of US, but Max Factor and CoverGirl are basically the same thing. They're very similar. So she bought a CoverGirl primer for me that is supposed to be like the Max Factor primer, but in a squishy tube. I'm so excited to get that package. She lives in Canada, I live in Denmark, and that shipping time is forever and ever, so I've gotten a primer in the meantime, and that is okay. It's fine. It keeps on my makeup, and I'm happy about that, but dang, I miss this so much. One thing I don't miss is the cap. It's never set on this, so that's sad. But this one, so good. So sad. But yeah, that is everything for my empties. I know it's not a lot, but it was short and sweet. Not really. I've been here for a very long time. Apparently in the summertime I don't use up many items. There wasn't many empties in June either, so maybe August is better. But that is also summertime. I don't know what is going on. I have a few products on the last legs, but they are not going to be done in July. So hopefully, crossing my fingers, they are going to be done in August, so I have some empties for you guys, and that my empties can be bigger. So I hope you guys enjoyed this small video. Like if you did, subscribe down below so you don't miss out on my next empties or my pretty pants updates. And I will let you know about the primer when I get it and test it out. I will test it out for you guys so I can compare it, and I have some requests to do that, and I'm really excited. Rebecca wants to see it as well. And I just realized my palm tree is dying. Nice. Oh, hashtag no green fingers. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and on to my next one. Please take care. Bye.